Hello everyone. Have you ever thought how a human body is? How do we walk, sleep, think, and perform different work? How our body functions? Our body does not function automatically. The nervous system helps in controlling and coordinating various activities of the human body. Humans dream while sleeping. We cannot just dream anything without any process in the brain. Each of our body systems are interconnected and dependent on each other. Our body is made up of different parts and internal organs, and all function differently, like brain, hands, lungs, backbone, and many other. So all parts of our body help us to perform different activities. Let us take an example. If we put our fingers on fire, will you not sense anything? We feel hot and the message is immediately sent from the body to the brain. Then the brain starts function and it commands us to remove our hand from the fire. So the brain is the command center for our body. It controls and coordinates the functions of our body, which is very important. In this video, I will tell you about the human body and its functions. Anatomy. What does this mean? Let me tell you. Anatomy is a part of biology. It is related to identify and description of the body structures of living things. So human anatomy means the study of the human body parts and their function. In this we study in detail the systems of the human body and the functions of different internal organs and tissues. We learn about lungs, intestine, nerves and veins. So it is the scientific study of the body structures of living things. There are different parts of our body through which we are able to do different activities, such as running, jumping, walking, lifting objects through our hands, and many more. So different organs and parts cooperate to keep the body running. I have a question for you. Is the human structure the same across our body? No. We have different shapes on our body. Our face and head is circular. Internal organs have different structures and forms. Our hands are long and straight. So different parts of our body are in different size, shape, and form. How does our body work? Our body consists of different organs. Inside our body, we have heart, intestine, and many other organs. The heart is a muscle which is located inside of our chest. It is not simply an organ. From inside, heart is divided into many parts. Similarly, each organ of our body has its subparts. The human body is composed of trillions of cells. They provide structure and support for the body. Just like heart is divided into many parts, similarly, each organ of our body has different parts. Human physiology studies the nature of the human body. We perform different works through our body. But it doesn't mean that every person is capable of doing all kinds of work. Each person has a different level of strength and capabilities. Some people have thick muscles and they are physically strong, so they have more strength. And some people are skinny, so they have less strength. They look thin and they are physically weak. Is it possible for them to do heavy work? No. They can do work according to their strength. It depends on the capability and physical endurance of different persons that how much work they can do. Each person has different level of strength in their body. So one should not do work more than their stamina, because it is very important to protect our body from any harm. Human body consists of various internal organs, tissues, and cells. And each organ are interconnected and dependent upon one another to function. If the connection breaks between the organs, then the body will not function properly. So it is important that different organs of our body work together. Let me give you an example. The function of each of our body parts is different. Neck rotates in 180 degrees. However, does our arm rotate at the elbow? No. The capacity of hand to rotate is different from that of neck. When we move our hands, chest, stomach, and other parts, they move in a different way. Let us take another example. When we grab a heavy object, the muscle contracts and brings bones together due to the arrangement of muscles and bones. And when we lift lightweight object, the muscle does not contract much. But lifting heavy objects will create stress on the muscles and tissues. So physiology focuses on function or how structures at different levels work. It is important to understand both anatomy and physiology. Both are closely related. Anatomy, the study of human body, such as heart, lungs, intestine, veins, shoulder, head, brain, spinal cord, and all the other parts. And physiology are important in physical education and sports, such as cricket, football, hockey, tennis, and other. So anatomy and physiology are very important subjects. The studies of human body movements and effects of exercises on human body are performed only with the help and knowledge of anatomy and physiology. We all know in physical activities, exercises, performances, and sports, we use the human body. A physical education teacher, coach, and sports scientist must have knowledge of anatomy and physiology. A physical education teacher is a professional who is responsible for developing exercise-based learning to teach students about sports and health. Coaches are responsible for teaching relevant skills, tactics, and techniques of sports. Sports scientists help people to improve their sports performance or general health. They help people to recover from illness through a structured program of physical activity. Now, I'll tell you the points which a physical education teacher, coach, and sports scientist teach their students about physical education. The study of anatomy and physiology helps in evaluation of a player's capacity. Different players and sports person have different endurance capacity. There are certain players who are physically very strong. They can endure strenuous physical activities. Hence, coaches and trainers need to train according to their endurance levels. And there are some players who are not very strong physically. They are encouraged to learn such sport which they can easily play according to their strength and capacity. And there are some people who are physically weak, but they can also participate in sports. So they need to be trained in such sports which are easy for them to learn. So the study of anatomy and physiology are essential to know physical education and sports from scientific point of view. We all do exercises to maintain our health. What are the rules of exercising? Let me give you an example. If we do the gym exercises and lift the equipments in a wrong way, will it help us to tone our body? No. Exercising incorrectly can negatively impact our body muscles, ligaments, and tissues. Hence, gymming should always be done in the presence of a trainer. He will guide us with the correct method and positions during exercise to build our muscle strength. So a physical trainer helps us in doing proper exercises. If we do it correctly, then it will build up our fitness and muscle tone. So personal trainers are very important. Various categories of training and workouts helps in understanding positioning of the body during training sessions. In this, people learn different topics related to physical health, which help them to take proper care of their body. Players and sportsmen endure injuries when they are in action. This can be a face injury, a hard swing, or it could be a fracture or a displaced bone. Hence, it is important for the physical trainer or sportsperson to understand the precautions to be taken to avoid injuries. The guidance of a physical trainer helps the players to prevent themselves from sports injuries. Healthy diet and nutrition is very important to play different sports. Players should follow well-balanced and timely diet to be healthy, fit, and energetic. There are different sports such as cricket, football, tennis, and many more. Sometimes players get injured while playing. They get hurt by fractures, tennis elbow, knee injuries, and so on. In that situation, they are immediately taken for the treatment and are provided proper care. A severe injury may lead to an exit from the sports for the player. In that situation, proper medical attention is given to them for their speedy recovery from sports injuries. This helps them to recover in short time. So the study also helps in speedy rehabilitation from sports injuries. There are different players. Each player has their own interests and skills. Some like cricket, some like football, some like badminton, and many more. A passionate player set a goal in his life to achieve something. This helps in improving the sports performance of a player. There are different players who have different capacity levels. It is very important for a player to choose any sports activity as per his body capacity. This will help them to improve in their field. In different training sessions, players learn all the rules and regulations of their sport. These trainings also help them to learn about the ill effect of alcohol to human body and to do proper care of their health, to be healthy and fit. I hope you all have understood the points which I have told you. You must learn this. If we have knowledge about our body parts and its functions, then we can do exercises properly for each body part. So in physical education and sports, the knowledge of anatomy, the structure of the body, internal organs and its functions, and physiology are very essential. It is important to know about this, then we can do different physical activities. We all must know how to improve our health. It is very important to use our body for daily activities and to improve our body strength for a good health and a better life. I hope you all will learn the important points which I have explained to you in this video. After learning this, it is your responsibility to focus on taking care of your physical well-being by ensuring a good, healthy, and nutritious diet. This will help you to improve your health.